Hello, Facebook. Attorney Tim Anderson, January 14th, 2020, about 3:40 today. We are getting a similar question, and it has been coming in at rapid pace over the past few days. And that question is, why are immigration sanctuary cities legal, but Second Amendment sanctuary cities are not, or have no effect, or have no legal bite? And I'm going to answer that question because I think there's a general misconception about what we're doing and what things are, how the law generally works. So first off, an immigration sanctuary city is a situation where the local government, the local police department of a particular city, refuses to enforce federal immigration law. All right. So immigration laws are federal in nature. And what a sanctuary city basically says is that I'm San Francisco, all right? San Francisco is not going to enforce federal immigration law. Now, that is legal according to the United States Supreme Court. The United States Supreme Court has ruled in many cases that the localities and states do not have to enforce federal laws. Federal, we have two forms of government in the United States. We have the federal system and we have the state system. And the laws on the federal side have to be enforced by the federal government, and the laws on the state side are enforced by the state government. So that's how our systems of government work. And so when a city says it's a sanctuary city for immigration purposes, what it's saying is that it's not going to use its local police resources to enforce federal immigration law. And that, again, is constitutionally valid. And it doesn't just have to be immigration, it could be any federal law. If a city said we're not going to enforce an EPA regulation, that would be something that they could do. Anything federal, the states don't have to. Now, they can, if they want to, if the communities want to use their resources, they can enforce those laws, but they don't have to. All right. Now, flipping that over to why sanctuary for the Second Amendment are not the same is it goes into what Virginia has, which is something called the Dillon Rule. And basically what the Dillon Rule says is that localities have no right to make a law that contradicts the state law. So when the state makes a law, the localities can make their own laws similar to that and turn those into ordinances for revenue purposes, but they can't make a law that directly contradicts a state law. So, for instance, if Virginia says that all private party gun transactions must go through a background check, which is universal background checks, then the city of Virginia Beach could not pass an ordinance that says you don't have to do that here because that violates the form of government that we have, which is followed under the Dillon Rule. Now, also, Virginia Beach cannot make a law that is not been already authorized to be made by the state legislature. So, even if there's nothing on point, if Virginia Beach said, we're going to make popsicles illegal, they couldn't do that unless the state had given them some type of authority to do that. That's how Dillon Rule states work. So, that's why you see the attorney general. And that's why I've said multiple times, sanctuary cities have really no legal effect in Virginia. They're political, they're big political statements. And if the politicians aren't going to listen to them, there's going to be political consequences to that down the road. But they don't have legal effect because a locality cannot make a law that is different than a state law. Okay. So that hope that question is answered. Please understand that if you are in a sanctuary city and laws start getting made, you have no sanctuary in that city from those laws. The law enforcement are required to uphold the law until a court says otherwise. So understand that that's how the system works, and you face prosecution by local police or local sheriffs or the state police if you are violating a law that the state makes. Okay. All right. I'm going to turn this off because I'm going to make another video in just a second. It's going to be talking about my school resolution. I want to show you a couple things, pretty interesting stuff. And then that'll be it for the day. Have a good day, guys.